Hi, this is Bill from the Maker's Guide, and today we're going to unbox a Shopfox adjustable mobile base. This adjustable mobile base from Shopfox will allow you to mount your tools onto it so that they can be easily moved and, once they're in position, leveled to the floor. Inside the box you have an instruction manual which leads you through the assembly of the mobile base. You also have these welded steel corner platforms. They already have threaded holes in them. There's also some boxes of hardware in here. In this case, this one is one of the stationary wheels. Another one of the stationary wheels. With the swivel casters. This is the other swivel caster. One thing I noticed when I pulled out the caster from the box is that a small piece of plastic dropped down to the ground. And this appears to be a spacer that goes in between the wheel and the housing. On the other caster, that's intact. So we'll have to be contacting the supplier and see what they will do about that. Okay, so this was the caster that had the broken part on it. Now, I just got off the phone with the supplier. Now, I bought this particular base from Grizzly Tools, and Grizzly is doing a fantastic job on this. I got off the phone with Ruth in customer service, and I told her what part was broken. No questions asked. She said, hey, we'll ship you another one. It'll be there 3 to 4 business days. How can you beat that? Great job, Ruth. Great job, Grizzly. The stand comes with two different types of brackets for the corners. The ones with this threaded rod portion here are for the leveler feet, and the others are for the straight casters. In order to assemble this, you're going to need a couple of metric wrenches, a 14 millimeter wrench and a 13 millimeter wrench. Each one of the caster assemblies is going to need 4 of the bolts, 4 lock washers, 4 flat washers, and 4 nuts. And these are 16 millimeters long. I looked at the base and where I was going to put it, and I decided that the swivel casters were going to go onto the corners with the leveling legs. So we take a bolt in the washer, put it through from the top, then we attach the casters. Followed by a lock washer and a nut. Okay, we've got the first caster on, and we're going to repeat the process with the other ones, and then we're going to start on the fixed casters next. For the stationary caster, you got to choose which direction it's going to go. And that's based on which way you're going to have your tool lined up and are most likely to have to push it. So I looked at my machine, and that's the orientation that it needs to go in, because it's going to be mostly for pushing it forward and back. If it was going from side to side, I'd probably have put the caster in that way. I slipped the lock washer over the screwdriver because it's quite a tight fit in here, and I just tip it down, drop it up over onto the bolt. And I do the same thing with the nut. Oh, well, not quite as effective. That gets it into position in these tight quarters. And just a little bit of... attention, we get it started down, and then take a socket with a long extension, put it into place. And then make sure your assistant knows which one to be tightening. And you're done. I slipped the lock washer over the screwdriver because it's quite a tight fit in here, and I just tip it down, drop it up over onto the bolt. And I do the same thing with the nut. Oh, well, not quite as effective. That gets it into position in these tight quarters. And just a little bit of... attention, we get it started down, and then take a socket with a long extension, put it into place. And then make sure your assistant knows which one to be tightening. And you're done. And another tip my friend Jamie showed me on how to keep the nut into the socket while you're trying to reach into a difficult place. Take a little scrap piece of paper, place it over the socket, and then take the nut and push it in. The resistance from the paper is enough to hold the nut in place while you're maneuvering it down into where it's got to go. Simple. Okay, next we place the caster assemblies onto the ground and trying to get an idea of how they're going to go. We've got the ones in front are the swivel casters, and the one in the back are the fixed casters. Before we do the next step, we're supposed to put a little coat of oil on the ends of the tubes so that they'll be easier to get in and out as you make adjustments. Probably not quite as much as that. Yeah, you're right, it's messy. Okay, next we slide the tubes into the brackets. Yep. And we do the same for the other side. Give you a rough idea of what size you're going to need. Each one of these rails has a line scribed on it that says max on it, and it tells you how far apart you can put the for the largest machine base. Okay, you want to get them roughly parallel at this point. Okay, move the base of the G0704 over onto the top of the parts, and now I'm going to adjust the width of it by tilting it to one corner and pushing in on the bars. Try and get the width right. Still have enough room. And you can see I'm quite long, and so we'll have to push in from the front. That seems about, probably about as close as we really want to go if we still want to get this in and out of here. Okay, the instructions say to take a nut and a bolt, and this is a nylon lock nut, and run it partially up onto the bolt. The easiest way we found of doing that was using a box wrench along with handy-dandy impact wrench. Get that going far up. Then these go down into a threaded hole in the base here. And you tighten that in there, and when you get it in place, you lower the nut down to lock it in. Okay, so basically this is how it works. This gets screwed in here. Tighten it down. When you get it tight, then you take your wrench and tighten the other portion down to lock it in place. Trying to get an angle where you can see this on the camera. There. And then you repeat that all the way around the base. Okay, we've got all the bolts secured and everything's in place. And now we need to put the leveler feet in. It's a plastic leveler foot. And then these threaded star knobs. And there's a magnet in one of these. See the two stick together. So you have a friend help you. And what you do is you just get this started in a few turns, and then raise the base up and slide that in. Lower it back down, and when you get this in place, start pushing up against this to level your machine. Now you notice this is rocking quite a bit here. As we were assembling it, we noticed that this base doesn't sit quite flat inside of here, and we can adjust that, and we will now that we've got everything in place. The cool thing about these floor levelers is when you decide it's time to move, you just loosen the bolt, the magnet takes effect, and you can see that it's lifting that pad with it. And so now it's ready to roll. When you get it in position, tighten it back down. And your machine is in place. weld it around. When you get it into place, just drop down foot pads. There you go. Level, sturdy, not going anywhere. Well, there you have it. The Shopfox adjustable mobile base. We've done the assembly. There are a couple of minor issues, but nothing insurmountable. This will make it a lot easier to move this milling machine around in the shop. These mobile bases come in a variety of sizes. There's larger and smaller versions of each. And you should check the dimensions of your machine to see which size you'll need for your machine and your application. Thanks, I'm Bill Griggs for themakersguide.com. Please remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel and to like us on Facebook and Twitter. Thank you.